Yeah, Llama 3 is a game changer in generative AI. It's also open source. This is awesome, right? Llama 3 comes into version 8b and 70b. Let me show you the performance of instruction models. As you can see, the Llama 3 8b model outperforms Llama 2 70b while being an 88% smaller model. This is amazing, right? Today, using Ollama, we'll cover how to chat with Llama 3 locally. To show this, we boot a simple chatbot app with Streamlit. Here is the app we'll create. We'll have a text area where we'll enter the prompt and a button to generate text. First, we write a prompt and then click on the generate button. After that, the app will create a response. To run this app, we'll use Llama 3 8b and 70b locally for free. Let's take a look at the topics we'll handle. First, we'll create a virtual environment and then install the tools we'll use. Next, we'll initialize Llama 3 with Ollama. Lastly, we'll boot the app with Streamlit. Awesome! We've seen the topics we'll cover. Let's go ahead and start with the setup. To write our code, we're gonna use the VS Code editor. Now, let's create a virtual environment. To do this, we're gonna use conda. Let's write conda create dash n. Let's name Llama 3. I already created this. After that, we're gonna activate this environment. Conda activate Llama 3. Here you go. Our environment is ready to use. The next step we're gonna do is install the tools we'll use. To do this, let's create a requirements.txt file. Requirements.txt. After that, let's create the library we'll use here. To run Llama 3 locally, we're gonna use LangChain and LangChain community. Okay, to build the app, let's write Streamlit. For now, these tools are enough to build the app. We're gonna now install this. It's simple to do this with pip. Let's write pip install -r requirements.txt. Here you go. Our tools are ready to use. To write our codes, we're gonna create a Python file. Let me click on the new file and then give a name, app.py. Yeah, our file is ready. So far, we created a virtual environment and installed the tools. Let's go ahead and initialize the model with Ollama. Ollama allows you to run open source LLMs such as Llama and Mistral locally. All you need to do use these models is download these tools from the website and then install it on your computer. After installing, you can use these tools in your terminal. To show this, let me go to our terminal. To start Ollama, first we're gonna type Ollama serve. Ollama serve. Nice! Ollama is ready to use. Ollama includes many open source models. You can see these models on the Ollama website. Go to the website and then just click models. There you go. There are many models here. Let me click Llama 3. Here is the Llama 3. You can select the version you want. You can see the 70b and 8b version here. This is very simple to load a model with Ollama. Let me show you. Let's go to the terminal and then open the new command prompt. To pull any model, use just Ollama pull command. Ollama pull Llama 3. There you go. This is simple, right? To see the loaded models, use Ollama list. Ollama list. There you go. The models will use Llama 3 8b and 70b. Cool. Our model is ready to use. Let's go ahead and initialize our local model with LangChain. To do this, we're gonna use Ollama class from LangChain. Let's import this class from LangChain community LLMs import Ollama. Okay. Next, let's initialize an object in this class. LLM equals Ollama. Let's pass model. Let's specify Llama 3. Nice. Our object is ready to use. Let's go ahead and generate a text using this model. To do this, we're gonna leverage the invoke method. Print LLM dot invoke. Let's write tell me a short joke. At this point, we're gonna add the stop token to prevent the infinite loop. To do this, let's set the stop method. Stop equals. Let's give the stop token used for Llama 3. Let's pass EOT underscore ID. That's it. Let's run the app. For this, go to the terminal and write Python app.py. Let me press enter. Voila! Here is the response. Easy peasy, right? Let's test the Llama 3.70 version. To do this, we're only going to add the model to 70B. Let's run this app again. Python app.py. Let me press enter. Keep in mind that creating text will take some time. There you go. The model works very well. Let's go ahead and build the app. For this, we're gonna use Streamlit. Let's import this tool. Import Streamlit as st. Next, let's give a title to our app. st.title. Let's pass chatbot using Llama 3. Okay? After that, let's get an input from the user. To do this, we're gonna use the text area method. Prompt equals st dot. Let's call the text area method. Let's give a text. Enter your prompt. Okay. What we're gonna do now is add a button to the app. For this, we're gonna use an if. If st dot. Let's call the button method. Let's give generate. If the prompt is true, we wanna generate a response. If prompt. While creating the text, we wanna display a message. With st dot. Let's call discipliner method. Let's pass generating response. What we're gonna do now is generate the response and display it. To do this, let's use the write method. St dot write. Now, let's use the invoke method to generate the text. Let me copy this code and then paste it here. The next thing is to give the method our prompt. Let me delete this text and then write our prompt. Let me delete this print method. Awesome! Our app is ready to use. We wanna use the 8B version. Let's run the app. To do this, go to the terminal and type Streamlit run app.py. Let me press enter. The app automatically opens in the browser. There you go. Our app is ready. Let's type hi, who are you? Let me click generate. Voila! Here is the response. Our app is up and running. If you want, you can see the output of the LLM token by token. To show this, let's go to the editor. Let's change the write method. Let me set write stream and replace the invoke method with the stream method. To test the app, let's go to the app and then click rerun. Now, let's create a response by clicking on generate. Voila! The response is writing with the streaming. This is cool, right? You can ask any question you want. Let's say, tell me a short joke about computer. And then, let me click generate. There you go. You can see the joke here. Let's go ahead and test the Llama 3.70 version. Let me go to the editor and then add 70B to the model. It's time to take this model. First, let's click on the rerun and then press the generate. This will take some time to work with Llama 3.70B. Yeah, it's done. Here is the response. Let's ask another question. What is the capital of France? Let me click generate. There you go. Our app works very well. Yeah, that's it. In this video, we covered how to build a chatbot app with Llama 3 locally. To create this app, we use Ollama and Streamlit. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.